Islamabad, as Pakistan's top civil and military leaders assembled in Islamabad on Tuesday to discuss the consequences of US President Donald Trump's harsh warning to the country just a day earlier, long-term viewers of the relationship were forced to tackle an often repeated question: can Washington and Islamabad remain friends or will they turn foes? This compelling question has frequently surrounded yet another question: can the US-Pakistan relationship become a long-term strategic framework for cooperation, or will it remain just a transactional one where Washington pays for every service provided by Pakistan and subsequently walks away, if it so chooses? This is a very unfortunate and irresponsible statement from the US President through an informal means on Twitter. US should not forget that Pakistan has lost over 70,000 precious lives besides suffering an economic loss of over $100 billion, DH $367 billion, in the US-led war against terrorism. Pakistan has made huge contributions by apprehending major Al-Qaeda leaders, and yet we remain underappreciated. We are no longer ready to take US accusations for the sins we have not committed. The fact that there is no tangible government in Afghanistan after over $1 trillion US investment indicates that US needs to rethink its foreign policy, Dr. Maria Sultan, defense analyst and director general of the South Asian Strategic Stability Institute, said. The unusual abruptness surrounding Trump's remarks indeed marks a departure from previous warnings by US leaders, notably former US President George W. Bush, who served former Pakistan President Pervez Musharraf with a tough warning after the New York terrorist attacks of 2001, known as 9/11. In sharp contrast to Bush's famous "either you are with us or ISA against us" line, which at the least gave Pakistan the choice and space for changing sides, Trump has been more direct. They, Pakistan, give safe havens to the terrorists we hunt in Afghanistan, with little help. No more, he said in an unusually harsh message. The past 1 year under the Trump presidency has provided ample evidence of a hardening of the US stance towards Pakistan. But the New Year's Day message from Washington has immediately changed the tenor of US policy. For now, it appears in public that either Pakistan comes up to Washington's expectations or lives with the consequences, without any apparent room for maneuver like after the 9/11 attacks. Then, abandoning Afghanistan's former Taliban rulers in a foreign land was relatively straightforward rather than dealing with difficult choices on the home front. Though Pakistan's Prime Minister Shahid Khaqan Abbasi on Tuesday summoned a meeting of key ministers and the military chiefs, the country's ability to quickly emerge from a crisis mode in ties with the US remained in doubt. Other than China, which has remained Pakistan's time-tested friend and which on Tuesday publicly called yet again for appreciating Pakistan's sacrifices in fighting terrorism, there were practically no voices from outside Pakistan in support of the country. The Chinese Foreign Ministry said Pakistan had made sacrifices in combating terrorism and the international community should notice the efforts made by Islamabad.